When a scientist who believes in evolution gets saved and experiences the spiritual transaction, they cannot easily give up a whole career's worth of indoctrination and training. And so the mind changes gradually. So basically all the scientists that I know who were saved took several years to work through their evolutionary thinking. And so I was like them. I spent several years in painful transition, re-examining what I thought must be surely true, and then asking, is it really true? How strong is it? And so like many of my colleagues who went through that, there were a series of eureka moments where I realized, I always thought that was true, but that part of it is clearly wrong. And so for me, that came when someone asked me to read Michael Behe's book, Darwin's Black Box. And Michael's book is great, and it just, you know, the arguments are very simple. But when I read them, I thought, I've been a biologist for decades. Why didn't these simple problems occur to me? And it's because I had never critically examined the paradigm that shaped my thinking. And so when I realized that fundamental things that as simple as irreducible complexity, if that is a serious problem for evolution, what other problems might be out there? And so I did begin to ask, what I'm trained in genetics within my own field, does it work? And I was afraid that my own field would be insurmountable. And as I started to look at what evolution, what natural selection could or couldn't do, I started to realize there are huge problems in my own field that are insurmountable obstacles to evolutionary theory. And that led to this 13-year quest to understand what selection can do and what selection can't do. My particular path of research for the last 13 years has been genetic entropy. And really what it's shown me is something strange. It's shown me that I live in a broken world. So genetic entropy, the decaying of all living systems, speaks powerfully of the fall and is just incredibly biblical in its implications. And if there was a fall, that gives us understanding why there's death, why there's suffering, why there's evil, why there's conflict in this world. And it gives us hope for restoration.